Hey, what's up guys, and welcome back to the channel. Today, I want to introduce a really cool plugin for After Effects called Autofill that automatically fills the alpha channel of a layer. Now, this type of effect is used all the time for reveals, transitions, and progression, and while there are loads of techniques for making these animations visually interesting, some subjects such as growing plants, flowing veins, and drawing blueprints are very time-consuming to trace by hand without using vectors and the stroke effect. Autofill, however, uses the raster image and works across a variety of use cases. So Autofill is a paid plugin, and while this is not a sponsored video, I highly recommend it. We're going to take a look at some examples of how to use Autofill, so if that sounds interesting, let's get started. For the first example, I have a simple plant, and I want to grow it from the bottom of the stem upwards. But quite a while ago, I made a video on how to create growing vines using the write-on effect, but the process is very slow and requires a lot of manual work. Autofill can do the same thing in just a few seconds. So I'm going to grab the Autofill effect. As soon as you apply it, the opacity of the image that you're going to reveal is going to be faded. This is just so it can provide a preview of what is going to be revealed first. Then you'll see a little target, so you can move this target down to where you want it to start. So in this case, I wanted to start at the bottom of the stem right here. And there's quite a few controls. So we're going to start on a really simple example like this one, and then we'll move up to more complicated things. So for this, we're just going to have a look at the radius. So you can have this start quite large, or you can have it start quite small. We're just going to leave that on the default. Preview this just by hitting spacebar to see what we get. So right away we can see how this is flowing around the contours of the shape, which is great, but we do have some issues. So the first thing is it is going a little bit slow, so we can increase the speed to something like 15. So now this is going to finish, but some of the stems are really, really slow. And we're having an issue here, if you notice, where this leaf overhangs the stem. As soon as Autofill reaches the leaf, it's going to start filling that in, which doesn't really make sense because this leaf needs to sprout from this stem. So of course, using this type of technique, it's not going to realize that this leaf is in front of this branch. If this was in 3D space, it's not going to know that. But there is a way that we can change the speed of specific parts. So Autofill uses a type of map called a speed map. So if we go up to Autofill, open up speed map, and by default, in the newest version of Autofill, it automatically gives you a speed map. So if you click on view speed map, it basically gives you a black and white image. The white areas mean that it's going to start filling faster over those pixels, and black areas means it's going to be slower. But instead of using the auto one, we can use a custom layer. So let's turn this off and let's duplicate this vector. I'll just call that speed map. And on the speed map, we don't need the autofill effect. And on the hue and saturation, we'll just drop that down so it's completely desaturated. And then let's grab an invert effect and then a curves effect. So I'm going to crush the black values down to something like this. So the branches and the stems are going to be faster than the leaves. And then inside the leaves, the veins are going to be faster. So if we turn this off, go back to our vine, and then change the mode from auto to custom layer. And on the layer, choose the speed map, and then effects and masks. This is taking this off the luminance, not the alpha, by default. And if we play this again, you can see that the branches and the stems grow a lot faster than the leaves, and overall we get a much better looking result. Now, to do this by hand would take a very long time to do, but with Autofill you can get something out very, very quickly. Right, so when you are happy with the result, you can uncheck preview input, then you won't see the faded image at the beginning, and then we get our final result. Alright, let's move on to another example. Alright, so here I have an abstract paisley shape, which looks pretty interesting. And if we solo this layer, we can see the alpha channel. And there is going to be an issue with this. So if we wanted to start autofill in the center, it reaches this section just fine and can cross into this outer ring. But as soon as it fills up that, since there's transparency here in the alpha and there's no pixels that connect it to the main body of this paisley, autofill is just going to stop. Alright, so let's grab the autofill again. We'll zoom in here. Place the autofill on the center, and then we can just play this forward. So as soon as it fills up this ring, it doesn't know what else to do. Fortunately, Autofill has a way around this. So there's a channel called border strength. So if I lower the border strength, something down to like 50%, and then play it again, you can see that now it kind of leaps over this blank area of the alpha, then can continue with the rest of the shape. So that's one way if you have lots of different pieces that are not attached to each other, it's still very easy to have it reach that point and then just kind of leap over the border. You can also do a similar thing by increasing the radius, but the border strength is a little bit more useful. If we lower the border strength to something like 10%, you can see that it can leap across even this middle section and start filling in these little swirls before the base reaches it. So it's a setting that you'd want to play around with to get the results that you want, but it's very easy to control. There are two other ways that we can grow the source. So one is from a noise and one is from a layer. It's going to look at the luminance, so white areas it can reveal from, black areas it cannot. If you have a specific image that you want to emit from, you can use layer. Otherwise, quite often you just want some noise. So instead of having to make a separate noise layer, this feature is built in. So if we switch this to noise, then we can switch this to view growth. And if we scrub along here, you can see we get some really sporadic noise, and this is where the growth would emit from. Now, this noise isn't really what we want, so if we go into the noise settings, we can start tweaking the parameters. So let's first start by decreasing the duration. This will make the noise expand faster. And then on evolution, if we hold down the Alt key and click the stopwatch, we do a simple time expression, so time times 10. So now the noise is going to be undulating. So if we turn the view growth off and then take a look, we get a very organic looking growth, which looks really cool. So other things you can do with this, we could change the offset. So there's a specific part that we want to have start sooner. We can just offset this. So if I just move this over something like 250 and negative 500, we could just play around with where the noise is actually starting. I'm also going to increase the speed just a little bit. So I kind of like that one a little bit better. Now there's quite a few other options in here. So if we open up compositing, so probably the most common one that you'd want is to fill it in with a color. So instead of just revealing it, you could add a color over the top of it. Unfortunately, you can't use a texture directly. You would have to use this as a matte to control that. But if you just want a solid color, that can be pretty useful. You can also composite it over the top. So if I wanted to overlay that color on the top, I can do that quite easily without having to create extra layers. I am actually not going to use that. And then there's some other view control, so you can see where the border is, and you can expand or contract the border. So this functions in a similar way to a simple choker. We open up advanced. We also have the option to blur. If you want the progression to be a bit softer, you can do that, but you can also use this effect in conjunction with the roughen edges effect. So roughen edges. So if we lower the scale down to something where you can begin to see the edge looking a little bit more rough, you can also increase the sharpness a little bit. So that's also a useful option. You can also increase the border or decrease the border, but you have to be a little bit careful with it. Otherwise, you are going to start cutting into the overall shape as well. But if you just use a really small border, it can lead to some pretty interesting looking results. So once again, when you're ready to render this out, you just uncheck preview input and go ahead and render. So one last thing, after you've already run autofill, if you notice any type of weird glitching or something isn't updating properly based on your changes, go ahead and click resimulate. This will clear the cache for this effect and just make sure that it's being resimulated from scratch. So you can click space or you can click resimulate. Resimulate just clears the cache. So this is the result that I came up with really, really quickly, and it's just such a time saver. So you might think that you could easily do this with a fractal noise, and yes, you could. But the problems with just using some kind of fractal noise to reveal this means that you're not going to have parts of the object reveal or grow in a sensible way. So if you notice here, all of these bridges connect outwards to the center, which is what you would expect. All of the lines flow in the direction that you would expect them to flow as if they're being traced. So if you are using noise, however, you will get areas that kind of spawn in the middle of nowhere, but that's just based on the growth source that we chose. But from this point, the edges will flow in a sensible direction. Now to do this by hand with a write-on effect would be extremely tedious. And the only really sensible way to do it, in my opinion, would be to trace the graphic. So if you don't have a vector already, you could use the layer auto trace, but auto trace is not particularly accurate and you're better off just using Illustrator most of the time, unless you need to trace motion. But even then, it often requires a lot of cleanup in order to get really clean edges. So from there, you could add a stroke effect, but autofill saves just a massive amount of time. All right, let's have a look at this final example of a maze. So for this example, instead of using autofill directly, we're going to use it as a mat. So we have a texture here that's going to be hidden as the maze is filled in. So if we go inside this maze mat, this is the graphic that we're beginning with. So just a quick note, autofill does require you have some kind of alpha. So if you only want it to fill, for example, this maze, if we take a look at what this looked like before, I can turn off the shift channels effect. I basically just had a black and white image. So if you wanted the opposite of this, you could simply use an invert. But with shift channels, you can basically select the luminance and just remove the luminance automatically. You could also use an extract effect or some kind of key effect, such as a key light or luma key. But in this case, I just used shift channels. I also used a simple choker just to expand the edges. So I don't really want to dive too deep into what I did to set up the effect, but just to bear in mind that you do want an alpha channel. So if you are just kind of stuck Don't forget about the shift channels effect. All right, so I'm going to toggle the transparency and then add the autofill effect. So once again, we get a preview. And if I zoom in here and move one point down here to the start, or to one of the starts, and move that there. And if I want another point, I can click on point count and you can have up to 5 points. So if you want more than 5 points, you could use multiple layers and multiple autofill effects, or you could use the layer effect. So you could manually draw on the points that you want and it would start from there. In this case, I'm just going to click 2 and then go ahead and place the second point up here. So for the radius, I'm actually going to drop this down to 1. So it's much smaller at the beginning. So we just want to make sure that that is in there so we can see it, something kind of like that. For the speed, do something like 12. And then for the speed map, if we open this up, I actually created a custom image here, basically just a bunch of snowflakes. So wherever the snowflakes are white, it's going to be faster, and wherever they're darker, it's going to be slower. This is going to just help roughen the animation a little bit, and we get some really interesting looking results. Let me turn that layer back off, go back to the maze, go back to autofill, and then I'll select custom layer. I'll grab the speed map with effects and masks, and you can also view the speed map here as well. You can see directly without having to turn this layer back on, and then we'll just drag out our timeline and preview this. As soon as this starts growing out, you notice how it kind of wraps around the corners. So as it wraps around, we get this kind of a nice rough effect. So you can use roughen edges, but you can also just use a speed map with a lot of detail on it. I really like how it curves around the sides there. It's kind of fun to watch it progress through the maze. All right, so I'm happy with this. So I can uncheck preview input, then back out to the main layer, then preview the main comp. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and render out the final result. For these examples, I've only shown static examples of images, but this also works with motion too. All right, guys, I hope you enjoyed that little overview of autofill. If you like this type of content or have any other software plugins that I should take a look at for After Effects, let me know in the comments down below. So if you enjoyed the video or you learned something, that like button really helps me out. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time. Peace.